What are the worst things for your kites? I mean, aside from fire, theft, rebar, trees, or hydro poles. The answer may surprise you, as these are things that we are all guilty of exposing our kite to on a regular basis. In fact, it's the frequency of exposure to these things that make them so bad. And often, we don't even think twice about it. All right, let's get into it. Number one is the sun. Just like we apply sunscreen to our skin to prevent sun damage, modern kites are treated with UV protection. However, just like sunscreen, it doesn't last forever. UV rays break the bonds and polymer chains, which cause material to weaken. This is why older kites are much more prone to tear, as the material simply isn't as strong as it once was. There is discussion that UV resistance is dependent on the color of the fabric, and that black is the most UV resistant of them all. We decided to test this out by leaving three different colored fabrics in our backyard for over a month. Let's take a look and see what we've got here. It's really hard to see right now because this is wet and dirty. We recently had some rain, so we're gonna clean this up and we'll give you a better look. All right, guys, now we've cleaned this up and you can have a better look. Let us know in the comments below what you think. As you can see from holding it up against the sun, you can definitely see where there's been UV damage. Given that kitesurfing is an outdoor sport, there's really not much you can do in terms of reducing exposure while you're on the water. However, once you are done, you can just pack up your kite or move it into the shade. Something else that's related to the sun is heat. If you're storing your kite in the trunk of your car, for instance, that can also be damaging, as the heat can cause the valves to delaminate, which ultimately can cause your kite to leak air. Some people say never to leave sand on a kite, as it will cause the fabric to wear faster. I'm not too sure about that, but one thing I do know is that in 20 knots of wind, a lot of sand can get blown away rather quickly, leaving your kite exposed to being blown away. That's why we recommend using a sandbag instead of sand. Another thing to watch for is getting sand in your bladder while pumping your kite. Many people have told us that this will lead to tiny pinholes in your bladder over time, and as we've experienced, that does tend to happen. As you can see just from this bladder alone, there's a fair amount of sand in here, or possibly even salt. You let us know what you think it is in the comments below. Finally, don't let your bar sit on the sand for too long. The weaving can open up if the lines aren't under tension, which allows for sand to get in. At the very least, it could shrink your lines or even worse, damage your lines, especially if you tighten pigtails that have sand in them. It's always a good idea to rinse your bar with fresh water after each session. It's also a good idea to check your quick release to make sure that there's no sand that can inhibit performance. Number three is wind. Yes, really. Ironic, isn't it? But when you leave your kite like this while you're taking a break on the beach, the trailing edge will flutter in the wind, which will cause the canopy to weaken. To show you the long-term effect of your canopy flapping in the wind, we left a piece of ripstop hanging out of our car window for about a month, and this is the result. Obviously, this is a little bit of an over-dramatization, but you get the point. So to lengthen the lifespan of your kite, you may just want to pack it up rather than let it sit on the beach, fluttering away in the wind. We hinted at this before, and just like sand, sea salt can be pretty detrimental to your lines if you don't take the appropriate actions. What happens when salt water dries up is that it will leave sharp salt crystals that will degrade your lines over time. For that reason, it's a good idea to rinse your bar with fresh water after each session. Even better, let it soak for a few minutes. We've also heard about salt finding its way into your bladder, especially if you have to do a self-rescue at sea. Again, these tiny little sharp salt crystals can cause tiny pinholes in your bladder. We kite primarily in freshwater, so we can't say this has ever happened to us, but we do have friends that have sworn that it's happened to them. Let us know in the comments below if you've ever noticed salt crystals inside your bladder causing tiny little pinholes. All right, so there you have it, the four worst things for your precious, precious kite. Let us know if we've missed anything below in the comments, or if you have any tips to lengthen the lifespan of your kite. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.